Greetings, everyone. Once again, welcome to our video series for this subject, Experimental Psychology. I am Ezri M. Cota Jr., Assistant Professor 3 under the Psychology Program of the Arts of the College of Arts and Sciences at the Rizal Memorial Colleges. And for this semester's Experimental Psychology subject, I am the instructor. So for the newbies, for this video series, kindly support this YouTube account for more content like this one. And for my students, kindly follow my instructions I gave you for this video. For students not from this class or not from RMC, do not hesitate to give your comments, drop your comments, suggestions, or questions, clarifications if you have some for this topic that we will be discussing this video. So I think this is Chapter 7, the basic experimentation. The topic for this chapter is the basic experimentation. So in the previous chapters, we have discussed the introduction to experimental psychology, research ethics. We also discussed the various alternatives to experimentation, because not all studies we will be conducting in experimental psych are experimental in nature. So we also have discussed the alternative experimentations like surveys, correlational methods, interviews, and more of that. So right now, we will be discussing the basic of experimentation. Included in this topic are independent and dependent variables, operation definitions, evaluating operational definitions, and planning the method section. We'll be also discussing here validity and reliability and some threats to the validity of our experiments or our research papers, whether it is experiment or non-experiment in nature. So let's start. Now, what is IV? IV is the independent variable, or it is the antecedent condition an experimenter intentionally manipulates. For the experiment, yung IV natin is yan yung palaging minamanipulate natin. Why? Because in an experiment, ang lagi nating dapat isipin is that changes in the IV must be, or changes in the DV must be attributed to the IV or our manipulation, because that is the main characteristic of experiment talaga. We really have to manipulate our IVs. I hope that is clear. Ano naman ang confounding variables? Or minsan kasi may mga extraneous variable tayong tinatawag. Nagiging confounding ito kapag hindi natin ito nako-control. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng extraneous variable? Ito yung mga variables na we are not intending them to measure. Ibig sabihin, wala sa equation ang mga variables na ito, and they just simply appeared at the middle of our experiments, of our studies, and if we will not be able to address them or to control them, they will significantly affect the changes in our DV. It's because, ayun nga, no, nagiging confounding variables ito, no? Or nagiging another source of changes ito sa ating DV. V, or yung tinatawag nating dependent variable. Now, let's move on. Ano naman ang dependent variable? It is the outcome measure or the experiment. It is the outcome measure experimenter uses to assess the change in behavior produced by the independent variables. So, ibig sabihin, yung manipulation mo for the IV is intended to make a change or to make an effect to our DV. So yung recipient ng changes ng iyong IV because of your manipulation is your DV. So I hope that is clear, no? Now, moving forward. Ano naman ang ibig sabihin ng operational definition? No, this is opposite to conceptual definition. This because when we say conceptual definition, these are the bookish definition or by the dictionary or by the book, that is the definition. But when we say operational definition, it is specified, no, to the exact meaning, or it specifies the exact meaning of variable in an experiment by defining it in terms of observable operations, procedures, and measurements. Or ibig sabihin, you're defining a variable based on what you are trying to do to it on your study, or how are you going to use that variable to your study. So yan ang operational definition. Sinasabi natin experimental operational definition, no, it specifies the exact procedure for creating values of the independent variables. So yung independent variable mo, how are you going to use that in your study? How are you going to measure or to study that in your research? How are you going to use that in your research? Yan yung experimental operational definition, yung procedures natin for the IV. While measured operational definition specifies the exact procedure for measuring the different variables. Or parang mali ata ito, no? Or the dependent variable ito, variable. Clerical error po yun, no? So meron tayong types of measurement or levels of measurement, no, that which is very helpful kapag gumagawa tayo ngayon ng scale or gumagawa tayo ngayon ng measurement for our dependent variable. Kasi mini-measure natin ngayon, no, yung changes natin. So how are we going to measure them? Meron tayong tinatawag na NOEER, no? Or yung NOEER, which is a abbreviation for nominal ordinal interval saccharatio. When we say nominal scale, it is the it assigns items to two or more distinct categories that can be named using a shared feature but does not measure their magnitude. So, ibig sabihin, kinakategorize mo lang yung data mo. You already have the data or your output, no, from the result of your measurement or your study, kinakategorize mo lang. No, walang numbers. Or may merong numbers man, pero ang indication or ang interpretation yan is categories lang. No? So, hindi siya rank. Walang mas mataas or walang mas maliit or walang mas ma... nasa pinakadulo, walang ganyan. Kinakategorize lang ng data mo in a nominal scale. Now, if you have an ordinal scale, it measures magnitude of the dependent variable using ranks, but does not assign precise values. Wala pa ding values. Ranks lang. Sino yung nandun sa pinakataas? Sino yung nasa pinakagitna? Or pwedeng first, second, third, fourth, fifth, or rank lang. Ibig sabihin, rank lang ang ordinal scale. Pag sinasabi naman nating interval scale, measure magnitude of the dependent variable using equal intervals between values with no absolute zero point. Kaya interval kasi, kung gaano kalayo yung interval or yung 1 sa 2, for example, may scale siya na 1 or 2, kung gaano kalayo at gaano kalayo yung value doon sa 1 at saka 2, ganun din sa another extension ng value na 2 at 3, ganun din yung kalayo niya o yung value niya. Pero wala siyang absolute zero kasi hindi natin minimeasure dito yung wala tayong absolute or true zero dito kasi yung zero may value pa din siya. Example ng interval scale is yung temperature natin. Hindi ibig sabihin na 0 degree yung temperature natin, 0 talaga siya, wala talaga siyang temperature. Or negative 1, negative 2, or 3, or 0, nagsisimula sa 0. Hindi ibig sabihin na may 0, wala talagang value. Ibig sabihin maginaw. No, may value siya, maginaw, hindi siya mainit. maginaw siya. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng interval scale. Meron naman tayong ratio scale. Now, ang ratio scale measure the magnitude of the dependent variable using equal intervals tsaka may zero. So, ibig sabihin, may absolute zero tayo dito. No? For example, kilo. Kasi sa kilo, kapag zero yung timbang nito, wala talagang neto, wala talagang timbang. Ibig sabihin, walang kilogram. Okay? So, reliability naman. So, it refers to the consistency of experimental operation definitions and measured operation definitions. So, paano ba natin na-measure or na-ensure yung reliability natin? Ibig sabihin, gaano ka-consistent yung measurement natin. For example, you have a questionnaire. Kung reliable ba yung questionnaire mo? Na meron tayong tinatawag na inter-rater at saka inter-term. Saka test-retest meron din. Okay? Pag sinasabi nating inter-rater reliability is the degree to which observers agree in their measurement of the behavior. Ibig sabihin, inter-rater may magre-rate sa yung questionnaire. At based sa kanilang professional qualification, professional opinion, nag-a-agree sila sa measurement na ginagamit mo. Pag sinasabi naman natin inter-term reliability measures the degree to which different parts of an instrument, questionnaire, or test that are designed to measure the same variable achieve consistent result. So ito, ginagamitan talaga ito ng correlation. No? Every item ba na correlation or kinocorrelate yung half ng correlation or yung mga items ay dinidivide ng dalawa at saka kinocorrelate kung consistent ba yung scores. At meron din tayong test-retest. Sinasabi nating test-retest reliability, yung mga test takers natin ay pinapatake natin una at saka kino-compare natin sila sa another set, no? The same test takers, then pinaparetake natin sa kanila at then kino-compare yung scores nila. Kapag reliable or consistent or positive yung reliability coefficient, ibig sabihin reliable yung questionnaire nila. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng test-retest. Meron din tayong validity, no? Para sa isang research, questionnaire or measurement na ginagamit natin para sa ating research. Isasabi nating validity naman, kung yung reliability is yung internal consistency ng iyong questionnaire, yung validity ngayon ng questionnaire mo, is kung yung questionnaire mo is nagme-measure ba talaga siya sa ini-intend or what it purports to measure. Kung yung purpose ng iyong yung questionnaire is for intelligence test, dapat yung kanyang mga items ay yung mini-measure is intelligence talaga. Hindi emotional quotient, hindi din personality. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng validity. So may tinatawag tayo na face validity. So ibig sabihin, yung face validity na unang kita mo pa lang sa test mo or at a glance, no? By just simply scanning the pages of your test, you can really say na, ito math test ito. Ito abstract test ito. Ito intelligence test ito. So evident na pag unang tingin mo pa lang, ito ay isang intelligence. Valid na siya agad, no? In just a face value. Meron din tayong content validity. Sabi natin content, it is how we measure accurately a measurement procedure samples the content of the dependent variables. Yung content validity naman is yung every item, if valid ba siya. Nakukuha natin yung content validity is through professionals, mga experts. Nire-rate nila yan. No? Kung sakto ba ang question na ito for this variable na pinag-aaralan mo. For example, your test is to measure the intelligence tapos may question ka about personality, ipapalpak yan sa content validity ng iyong mga raters, yung mga experts mo. So yan yung ibig sabihin ng content validity. Meron din tayong predictive validity. Pag sinasabi nating predictive validity, it is an accurate measurement procedure which predicts future performance. Yung predictive validity is that gaano ba kalaki yung chance na yung test mo, measurement mo, ay pwedeng makapredict ng future behavior based sa iyong variable na minimeasure. So, yan yung ibig sabihin ng predictive validity. Now, internal, meron tayong internal at saka external validity. Yes, internal at saka external. Kanina napag-usapan natin kung ano yung external validity. External validity, or I think it's on the last chapter, no? Chapter 6. Yung external validity is gaano ba ka applicable sa general population ang findings mo or ang results ng studies mo. So, yan yung external. While yung internal is the degree which changes the dependent variable across treatment conditions or due to the independent variables. Yung internal validity is that kahit nireplicate, no, yung results or yung study mo, dapat yung result is the same. Kahit ilang replication na yan, dapat yung changes sa DV mo is always attributable to your DV or to your IV. Or ang cause ng changes ng DV mo is your IV. Yan yung internal validity natin. Now, we have threats to our validity, internal validity. Ano ba yung threats ng internal validity natin? No? Or kung ano ba yung threat sa validity ng ating results, no? Na hindi na siya pwedeng generalize sa other populations. Una-una, maturation threat. Ito ay sa part ng ating mga respondents. Kasi as a human, as an individual, we are bound to proceed to the next developmental stage in our life. Hindi man ito yearly nangyayari. Kasi minsan, it's just a matter of weeks. It's just a matter of days that you mature physically or psychologically. And that threatens our internal validity. Hindi lamang sa external, kundi sa internal validity din. Kasi yung manipulation ay maaring applicable sa ganitong stage ng kanyang physical at psychological stage. But if nag-mature siya physically or psychologically, another variable yun, no? Yung maturation. So, hindi mo yan makokontrol. Kaya kailangan na i-take note mo yan or i-consider mo yan upon choosing your respondents or your participants. Pangalawa is instrumental threat. It's when changes in the measurement instrument or measuring procedure threaten. Kapag may binago ka sa iyong measurement, or sometimes yung sinasabi natin na yung measurement mo ay nakita na ng yung for example, you are going to try test, retest, no? Or may ano ka, single subject, no, design. So, the same yan. Maaari na nakita na, desensitize na yung subject sa questions mo, the same question lang. So, pwede na naman manipulate. Or if may changes, binabago tayo sa ating instruments, pwede na maapektuhan yung ating output ng ating DV. Meron din tayong statistical regression threat, or it occurs when subjects are assigned to conditions or basis of extreme scores. Meron minsan tayong tinatawag na mga outliers sa ating statistics, na minsan may mga responses tayo na napakataas at meron din tayong responses na napakababa, na malayong-malayo sa normal distribution. So nakaka-apekto din 'yan, no, sa ating internal saka external validity. And lastly, meron din tayong subject mortality rate. So it occurs when subjects drop out of experiment conditions at different rates. So because we are protecting the welfare, the rights of our subjects, and it is part of our duties as researchers to always follow the ethical standards in conducting experiments. So we don't have the rights to parang force them to stay or to remain in our study. So whenever they want to stop their participation, so kailangan natin silang respetuhin. So that is also a mortality, subject mortality threat. Hindi sabihin na namatay. Or pwede din, no, natural, hindi because of your manipulation. But yung ibig sabihin ng mortality, subject mortality, is umaalis sa iyong research. Hindi na nagpapatuloy na makipag-participate. Method section naman of an APA research describes the participant's apparatus or materials. Ang apparatus section naman of the APA research report is inappropriate when equipment used in a study was unique or specialized, or when we need to explain the capabilities of more common equipment. Ayan, method at saka apparatus. That is important for the experimental study kasi you really have to describe step by step ano yung gagawin mong procedure. At pangalawa, apparatus, ano yung nomenclature ng yung apparatus? Anong mga apparatus yung ginamit mo? You have to declare that in your experiment. And I think that ends our presentation for this video, Chapter 7, the basic experimentation. And for my students, kindly follow the instructions I gave you for this video. And for the other students who are not from RMC or from this class, I hope you have learned something. Again, if you have questions, clarifications, or suggestions, recommendations, you might want them to drop to the comment section for me to answer them, no, if you have. And thank you so much for watching this video. Again, this is Ezri M. Cotto Jr., the instructor for the subject, experimental psychology. And I hope you learned something from this series. Thank you so much for watching and see you next video.